Another question is, private companies can choose to terminate workers who refuse to be vaccinated. Is this correct?
No, you cannot. You cannot terminate anybody because he refuses to be vaccinated. Oh, there is no legal basis.
Okay. And you are also urging paid quarantine and isolation leave for workers. Kasi maraming kumpanya, kung hindi ka empleyado, let's say, hindi naman casual, pero hindi ka empleyado, may iba kang kontrata. Kapag ikaw ay nagka-COVID, hindi ka bayad.
Hindi, basta yung empleyado, they're entitled under the labor code to leave credits, either vacation or sick leave credits. So, ang problema natin dyan, pag na-overuse na nila, nagamit na nila yan, what do we do with our workers? That is the reason why we came up with an advisory. Not directing or ordering, but urging our employers na kung maaari, dagdagan ang paid leaves ng kanilang workers. Especially if they're under quarantine or isolation.
Are you planning to come out with a special additional leave credit for workers that would go something like COVID credits? Parang ganon?
Ma'am Karen, that would be a good idea, but that will need legislation. We need Congress to do that.
Okay. What about the unvaccinated being required to pay for their own RT-PCR tests every 2 weeks? Attorney Cristina Acosta has said this is anti-poor and discriminatory against those who refuse to be vaccinated or cannot be vaccinated. Parang naging kasalanan pa nila.
Actually, hindi naman ito, what did you, discriminatory, because there is a substantial difference between a vaccinated and unvaccinated. So if you do not want to be vaccinated, okay, you can go to work, but before you go to work, you have to undergo PCR test. And that is also a privilege of management in order to prevent the contamination of the workplaces. They have to undergo yung PCR test. Kaya nga, to avoid that, magpa-vaccine na lang sila.
Tama. Okay, now, on another note, let's move on to other topics.
Apo.
There are 4.7 million displaced workers right now because of the pandemic. Ano ang ayuda or what kind of aid is the DOLE offering to 4.7 million displaced workers? That's a big number.
Karen, you are talking of a total number that is starting from 2020 pa yan. Yun, naayudahan na natin yung noong araw. Pero ang ating ina-address ngayon, yung mga naapektuhan na workers as a result of yung itong alert level 3. Diba? Because of the alert level 3, napaka-strict ang mga
process. Ilan po yun, Secretary? Apa? Itong naapektuhan ng alert level 3.
Yes, yan ang yun ang binibigyan namin ng ayuda ngayon. Pero although the estimate that there would be at least 100,000 to 200,000 workers that will be displaced because of alert level 3, our experience, and I'm very happy to note, na as of yesterday, ang na-displaced lang ng workers because of alert level 3 ay 11,500 plus. Aside from this, meron naman hindi na-displaced, pero yung kanilang working hours na-reduce under the flexible working arrangement. There are about 20,000 of them na nabawasan ang working hours nila. At dahil nabawasan ang working hours nila, Ma'am Karen, nabawasan ang kanilang kita, but their status of employment is secured. So yun po ang latest on the effect of alert level 3 on our employment status.
Okay, let's talk about workers going abroad, specifically with nurses. Ano na po ang latest, Secretary, with a cap on nurses? And in terms of the number that are now waiting for their visas or are leaving abroad?
Actually, Ma'am Karen, the IATF came up with the very recent resolution allowing a deployment cap of 7,000 for year 2022. So for the year 2022, we can deploy as much as 7,000 nurses
for
or healthcare workers. Opo. Pero may exception yan.
Ano po?
Ang exemption yan is that United Kingdom is exempted from that deployment cap. So anytime they can receive or we can deploy nurses to UK.
Interesting. Pag-usapan po natin ito. So, exempted ang United Kingdom. Hindi, kasi nakausap ko, I spoke with Philippine Ambassador to the United States, Babe Romualdez, last week. And he said the U.S. needs something like 100,000 plus nurses. And there are thousands of Filipino nurses waiting for their visas to be approved. So, ang UK has no cap. Kahit gaano karami ng Filipino nurses can go to the UK. Is that correct?
That's correct, Ma'am Karen.
Oh, what about the United States? How many do you have that are applying for the U.S.?
As far as U.S. is concerned, the 7,000 deployment cap applies.
I
and
see.
So with other countries.
Why is that? How did this decision come to be? Why is there a cap with the U.S. and none with the U.K.?
Well, I think it's just a question of, of fortune. Dahil even before we were running out of healthcare workers, the United Kingdom government requested for an exemption. And at that time, we were in a position to deploy as many healthcare workers that we want. Pero after that, na-realize natin na sa dami ng umaalis, baka darating yung panahon na tayo naman ang mawalan, lalo-lalo na ngayon, di ba? Lumalabas na rin na nababawasan tayo, nakukulangan na tayo ng healthcare workers. So yun ang they were just lucky na they were able to come up with the request even before we had a fear for running out of our own healthcare workers.
So with this, do we have a problem in terms of healthcare workers in the country? We do know that there are many health workers that are, kumbaga, that needed to be replaced also for a while because of COVID. You know, health workers also need to rest. So
kaya
hindi ba tayo mauubusan, Secretary?
Kaya nga po, that's why we have this cap, deployment cap, Ma'am Karen, in order to avoid the possibility of our government or our country running out of its own healthcare workers, especially so na tumataas yung COVID incident.
Mm-mm. Okay. Anything else you'd like to add, Secretary Bellio, before we go?
Wala lang naman, except na unang-una, I just want to be very, very clear na ang workers natin exempted. And then I would like to clarify yung news report kahapon na I am directing yung mga employers to give additional leave credits to workers, to their workers. That is not a correct interpretation of our labor advisory. Our labor advisory is only urging, pinakikiusapan ang mga employers to give their workers additional paid leaves. Pero hindi namin sila iniutusan. It is not mandatory. It is only, anong tawag dito, pakikiusap, urging them to be more compassionate and give their workers additional paid leaves. Kasi lalong-lalo na kung naka-quarantine sila o naka-isolate sila. So very clear yun na, Ma'am Karen, hindi namin inutusan ang mga employers. Pinakikiusapan namin sila kung kaya nila.
All right. Kumbaga, it's out of humanity and compassion.
Voluntariness and benevolence.
All right. Ayan. On that note, Secretary Bellio, thank you for joining me today.
Thank
and
you
a blessed
po.
New Year to you. Take care of
Happy
yourself.
Happy New Year, Ma'am Karen, and thank you again.